Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Right Reverend Stephen Kazimba Mugalu, has appealed to the government to carry out thorough investigation to find out those that have been abducted and to help return them to their families. The Archbishop made this call as he delivered his Easter message to Ugandans at the All Saint Cathedral in Nakasero. We have the report.
The Archbishop's call to government comes at a time when the country has continued to witness ugly incidents of people mysteriously disappearing. Although he's glad that some people have been found and reunited with their families, Kazimba says all those missing should also be sent back home or charged if found guilty.
Some of the youth who mysteriously disappeared have been found and reunited with their families. We are also aware that there are still others who have not yet been found. We stand with you in our grief and confusion. But take heart, God knows every hair on their head. And because He believes, we can face tomorrow.
The Archbishop also encouraged the government to lift the restriction on children attending church, saying they should be allowed at least 1 hour per week.
To receive our children for only 1 hour per week in an organized way that upholds the standard operation procedures, our children need to be in church with their families.
Kazimba also urged Ugandans to first consult on the AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine and make an informed decision to get vaccinated. The Church of Uganda this year is not hosting the Good Friday Way of the Cross because of the COVID-19 pandemic. The day will be observed in a scientific manner. Believers have been advised to follow the proceedings on TV stations, which will air it out live.
The Church of Uganda is hosting this year's Good Friday, Way of the Cross. My colleagues, Archbishop Ian Wanga and Metropolitan Jonah Wanga, will join me on this annual joint observance of Jesus' crucifixion and death. Because of salt, this year's observance will be small.
Good Friday is a Christian holiday commemorating the crucifixion of Jesus Christ and his death at Calvary. This story was compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.